Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we're going to talk about leading zeros. And the reason we're going to talk about this is I got a couple of emails of people saying, hey, you didn't put me on the map. I sent my entry in for the podcast 700 thing and I'm not there. And I went and checked and I had their email and I went and checked the file and they were in the file. You know, and when I did this matching, it went through and said, great, we matched all the records. But that's not true, it turns out. Here we have MapMeUSA. I'm going to double click here and it actually says, hey, I completely skipped 41 records. You skipped 41 records? Why didn't you tell me that? And it turns out when I go down here, it says, yeah, you had a whole bunch of records without any zip code information at all. So I went back to the original workbook and frequently when I have US zip codes, I know that there's leading zeros up in New England, so I always format those as text. And sure enough, right here around row 68, we had a whole bunch of text zip codes. I did that to keep the leading zero. Well, it turns out what we have to do is we have to convert those text values to regular values. Fast way to do that, data, text to columns, finish. And then if you want the leading zeros to show up, we use format cells. And there's a special format called zip code. Now, this is really just basically a way of creating a format that is five zeros, does the exact same thing. So once I re-imported this data, sure enough, there are a whole bunch of additional records up here in New England that were not included before. So this is the actual map. Now the good news is you were in the drawing because you were in the Excel file. This five-digit zip code, we'll take a look at the custom number format. If we click custom, it's simply a matter of putting in five zeros. And it reminded me of a problem that I frequently have that I always take the long way to solve. Here we have some lesson numbers from lesson 1 up through lesson 115 or so. And I want to create a consistent file naming structure for the Excel file that goes with those lessons. And frequently, what I do is I come here and I do a concatenation equal lesson. And I want to have leading zeros. So it's lesson 001 that we'll sort correctly in Windows Explorer. And so what I do is I end up using the right of a couple of zeros, ampersand the lesson number, comma 3. So what this does is it will take, for example, for lesson 115, I'll end up with 00115 and the right three digits will be 115. But for lesson 1, it'll be 001 and the right three digits are 001. Ampersand.xls. So there we can create a nice file name and copy that down, and that's usually the method that I use. But it turns out that that really is going through a whole lot of extra work. What we could do instead is take equal in quotes lesson and then use the text function. The text function says take that value over there in A1 and format it in the 3-0 format, ampersand.xls. And very quickly, without having to use the write function, without having to append those extra zeros, we come up with leading zeros for all of our records. Well, hey, there you have it. Sorry to everyone who was not included in the original map. Good news is you were in the drawing, and we learned something about leading zeros, problems with map point and text zip codes, and also a cool way to make sure that your leading zeros show up when you concatenate text. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.